everyone. We have here with us Sanidhya Dhakera, All India rank 482 in CS and All India rank 686 in DA Gate 2024. So my heartfelt congratulations to you, Sanidhya.
Thank you.
So starting off with the first question that I have in my mind for you is, when did you decide to start for Gate examination preparation?
First of all, thank you for having me here. And the first time when the thought of GATE examination came into my mind was after 12th, when I gave my JEE Advanced and the results were not quite satisfying. So then I started researching what are the other options through which I can still achieve my dream. So that was the first time when I came to know about the GATE examination. Secondly, when I just visited the college, there was something in mind like let's explore this college, and I started joining committees. I just went into committees and became head in one. So my first 2 years went like this. But side by side, I was just even noting down about the opportunities I have. Like I made an Excel sheet in which I wrote GRE, TOEFL, IELTS placement and GATE. And I just used to mention pros and cons of each examination. And by the end of second year, after listing these down, I came to know that yes, GATE is the best examination for me. After that, through one of my seniors, which was very hard to contact because in our college, there is kind of very less GATE culture, so very less people give GATE. So through one of my contacts, I came to know about one of my senior who suggested me about mission GATE.
Okay, so as you said, you made Excel sheet about which exams you were supposed to give. So I suppose you must have had some strategy particular for GATE examination. Can you share with us?
So to be honest, when I first joined, I wasn't aware about the fact that our batch is kind of a mixed batch, that there were a few students who had joined 3-4 months earlier, there were a few students who had joined 1 or 2 years earlier. So when I joined, I was like, okay, this is a separate new batch, I will make new friends. But my first experience was like, I said hi to one person and I was like, okay. So then I went ahead and I just did whatever sir said. So like in my case, sir started off with maths and data structures. So what I did is I used to go home, just revise the concepts once for 5 to 10 minutes and then just used to solve the PYQs related to the concepts which were taught. And for the first 2 months, I just did this thing that I used to complete the PYQs which sir used to give related to the concepts. And then afterwards, till the start of September, I started giving mock tests related to the which were related to the topic wise tests. And like we were supposed to give even full length tests by that time, but since due to a bit of college pressure, I got late and I started full-length tests in December. So I won't recommend anyone to do this. Please start your preparation by your full-length test in October itself.
Okay, so coming to the mock test part, you must have had some point wherein your marks would have reduced and the demotivation that comes with it and all those feelings. How did you tackle them?
Yes, so that did happen few times. Like, I used to consistently get around 60-70 marks for few exams, and then suddenly my marks used to fall till 48. So like if there is a reduction of 5 to 10 marks, then it is okay. But when we see like there's a reduction of 25 marks, then it's a bit of serious issue, like what's going on. And it wasn't like that the exam was too hard. Even in those examinations, few students of our classes used to score 72-78. So at that time, instead of getting, yes, obviously I used to get a bit demotivated, but then what I used to do is like just analyze the questions, which I couldn't do, and just used to see the solutions, because obviously sometimes we used to get in mind that I wasn't able to solve. So first of all, I used to give them as a try that try them as a questions only. And then I used to check the solutions for the ones which were time consuming, and just I went on.
Okay, so let me tell you all, Sanidhya is a fourth year student and this was his first attempt wherein he cleared his GATE examination. So how did you manage your fourth year engineering along with your GATE examination? I mean the time management, the pressure and everything.
Yes, so it was quite a decision. Like I first consulted two of the students who started preparation for GATE in second year, and like I even had enrolled for the training and placement cell of our college. So the constraint was that if you have to sit for placements, then you have to cover 75% of the lectures of training, including the excluding the ones the 75% attendance which is required in college. So I had these two additional lectures which I additional constraints which I had to cover. So then when I used to ask these people, they used to say that, okay, we are not giving GATE because we aren't going to get time only. So that's why, as I said in the first question, that I got, it got very late to consult some of the seniors. Okay. Because I didn't get. So And I first of all I kept on going with both the things. Like I was giving few hours, 2 to 3 hours to gate, and was continuing with my placement. But around July I had to make a decision, because if I like what we say, if dono naav mein paav rakhoge to dono jagah se maar khaoge. So that's why what I did is I decided okay, I am comfortable with a gate, so I will take a risk, and I was kind of confident that I can do this. So I took a drop from placement, I removed my name, and then I started preparing for gate full-fledged.
That's cool. Now, many aspirants at the age we are, the social media is one of the most like basic distraction, what some people call. What would you call social media as?
Okay, so like even I saw many videos of, I won't say that they are completely wrong, but they used to say like study for 18 to 20 hours, quit everything, sacrifice everything. But what I experienced is, you don't exactly need to do that way. Obviously, you have to give majority of your time studying, but there's no need of quitting everything. Because what I saw is, when you once get interest, if agar tumhara interest hi nahi aa raha kisi subject mein, to even if you give 18 to 20 hours, you are just rotting the answers. Matlab tumhe kuch exactly samajh nahi aa raha, tum karke aa rahe ho. Bas tum jaise jaise sikhate ja rahe ho, tumne jo question attempt kiya, tumne samajh liya iska aisa method hota hai, main aise hi solve karunga. To real life mein aisi cheeze work nahi karti. What you have to do is, you have to feel the questions. What we used to do is, we don't used to ask sir ki sir ye kaise ho raha hai, how is this working. So we didn't used to just see that what are the steps to do this question. We used to see whether we are getting the feel of the question. So what do I mean by getting the feel of the question is, ki ye question aisa kyun hua, iske piche kya logic tha, kya isme basic concept use hua, aur basic concept use hua hai to kyun is way mein hua, agar kuch bhi thoda twist hota tha question mein,
the different approaches, right?
Yes, exactly. So even we used to ask sir many times the same doubt, and even we used to get scolded also. But yes, even sir used to say that you get scolded but you clear all your doubts. So that was the thing. So we used to ask doubts which were even off track, but they helped us ultimately.
Yeah. So coming forward, like when you start with a journey, a special journey of preparing for gate examination, it's not just our personal contributions, right? So whom do you count as people or situations that have contributed for your success right now?
Okay, so I would say that my success was incomplete without three of the factors. Factor number one was obviously our professor RSV sir, Khan sir used to, who teaches about UPSC examinations, and Super 30 batch ke Anand sir. And I was lucky enough, fortunate enough, ki I got to study from one such professor in the form of RSV sir, who जो हमें सिर्फ पढ़ाते नहीं थे, बट ही यूज टू मेंटर अस, ही यूज टू गाइड अस, एंड समटाइम्स एज अ फ्रेंड भी वो हमें समझाते थे कि डीमोटिवेट मत हो, ये होता रहता है, एंड इसको इस वे में तुम ओवरटेक कर सकते हो सिचुएशन को. सेकेंड फैक्टर वॉज ऑब्वियसली माई पियर ग्रुप. दे नेवर थॉट दैट दिस इज अ कॉम्पिटिशन, सो ओके वी विल टेल हिम समथिंग लिमिटेड एंड वी विल जस्ट मूव अहेड. मैं उनसे एक डाउट पूछता था, एंड दे यूज टू सिट विद मी फॉर 1 आवर अंटिल लाइक मेरा वो डाउट समझ में, जैसे आई सेड दैट जब तक वो फील नहीं होता ना क्वेश्चन, तो मेरे साथ एक घंटा बैठते थे, मेरा डाउट क्लियर करते थे. लाइक उनके मन में कभी वो फीलिंग था ही नहीं कि अरे ये तो काइंड ऑफ कॉम्पिटिटर है या कैसा भी है. दे यूज टू टीच अस, लाइक दे यूज टू गिव देयर सो मच टाइम टू मी. सो पियर ग्रुप वॉज वन इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्टर. एंड थर्ड फैक्टर इज ऑब्वियसली माई पेरेंट्स, क्योंकि सिंस आई वॉज जस्ट दादा स्टूडेंट, सो मैं हफ्ते में 2 बार लेक्चर अटेंड करता था. तो जैसे वीकडे का जो मोटिवेशन होता है वो मेरे पेरेंट्स देते थे मुझे, कि करते रहे कोई बात नहीं, कुछ गड़बड़ हो रही है तो यू कैन कवर इट अप.
Okay, so coming to the end of this interview, I would want to know, what are the advices that you would want to give to the future aspirants for 2025, or some mistakes that you have made and you wouldn't want them to do so? So, such advices, please.
Yes, so first of all, I would like to tell about the mistakes which I did and I don't want anyone else to do. Number one, jo sab karte hain, jo matlab halka nahi okay. Number one is concentration issues, ki that is kind of natural, like you can develop that once, ki you are studying one thing, to mera concentration thoda lambe time tak nahi baithta tha. Like I used to sit for 10 hours, still I would say ki agar main 10 ghante baitha hu to mera effective study time would be 6 hours. So 4 hours like I am sitting in front of laptop, but mujhe nahi pata ki wo kahan waste hoga, ki mera effective study period jo mera calculated target hai wo 6 hours ke aapse pura hua hai. To ek wo factor tha. And second part is overthinking. मैं काइंड ऑफ हर सिचुएशन को बहुत ज़्यादा ओवरथिंक करता था, जिसमें मैं टाइम वेस्ट करता था, एंड एंड में रिजल्ट उतना हार्श होता नहीं था जितना मैं सोच रहता था कि अरे इसका ये होगा. स्पेशली इन केस ऑफ कॉलेज, मेरा जो मैंने कहा कि काफी मैं सीरियस हो जाता था उनके पॉइंट्स को लेके, इफ दे हैव वॉन्ट अस फॉर समथिंग तो नहीं ये सबमिट करना ही है, 75% अटेंडेंस बोला तो करना ही है, वो एक्चुअली मैनेज हो जाता है, बट थोड़ा ओवर थिंक कर लेते हैं हम कि हमें दोनों जगह थोड़ा बना के रखना है, हमें करना है. तो यू हैव टू टेक रिस्क एंड यस. सो इवन मेरी एडवाइस भी यही होगी कि ओवर थिंक मत करो, जस्ट गो विद द फ्लो. सर जो बोलते हैं वो करते जाओ एंड लाइक he guides us the best. So yes.
So thanks for your time and thanks for the interview.
Thank you so much.